Hi, in this tutorial we learn about areaportals. In one of my earlier tutorials I talked about visleaves. And an areaportal is kind of like a visleaf, but you can manually choose to close it or open it, and when it's closed it won't render what's on the other side of it. This is useful, for example, in doors or destroyable walls. Since entities can't block visibility on their own, you can use an areaportal to do that manually. And here's the level I've created for this tutorial. There are two rooms with three barrels in each and a door in front of each room. Let's create our area portal. Select the block tool, browse for textures, filter for area to get the area portal texture. And then create your brush. Press Ctrl T to tie it to an entity. Let's select the func underscore area portal entity. You can give an area portal a name. You can link it to a door, so when the door is closed, the area portal will be closed, and when the door is open, the area portal will be open. You can set an initial state for the area portal. If it's closed, it won't render what's on the other side. If it's open, it will render what's on the other side. So let's give a name to our door so we can link our area portal to it. I'm just going to call this door, door 1. And then set the name of the linked door of your area portal to door 1. And set the initial state to closed. Since the door will start closed, we want our area portal to start closed as well. And then we just need to place the area portal inside of the door. Remember to make sure that it's absolutely tight at around the edges. And let's compile this and see how it works. So here's our compiled map. First, let's open up the console and write sv underscore sheets 1. And then mat underscore wireframe 1. As you can see, it doesn't render what's on the other side of the area portal since it's closed. So type r underscore draw portals 1. When this is on, you will be able to see the area portals. Let's turn off the wireframe to make it more clear. You'll see that kind of green line around the door. There is none on the other door, so that's the area portal. Let's turn on wireframe again and open the door. You'll see it'll start rendering what's on the other side. And when we close it, it will stop rendering what's on the other side. You can also use the r underscore portals open all 1 and portals close all 1 to open or close the portals manually. So let's return to the editor. And let's remove the wall that is between these two rooms and recompile the map. Now you'll see that the area portal doesn't seem to work at all. This is because an error has occurred during the compile process. So check the compile process window, and over there you'll see brush 892, area portal brush doesn't touch two areas. This error happens when the same area touches the same area portal twice or more. And when that happens, the area portal simply won't work. So if you can go from one side of the area portal to the other side of the area portal without going through another area portal on the way there, that means that the area portal is leaked and won't work. So here I'm duplicating the area portal and putting it in the other doorway to fix this problem. Let's just give the other door a name. I'm going to call it door 2. And let's tie the new area portal to the newly named door. And recompile the map. And as you can see, the area portals now work. Now, here's another good feature about area portals. If an entity can't be seen through the area portal, it won't be rendered. And even vis leaves that can't be seen through the area portal won't be rendered either. And this can be used in many scenarios to optimize your levels. For instance, imagine you have two very complex rooms right next to each other. You can put an always open area portal in between them to make the amount of geometry that needs to be rendered much lower. So let's try to open and close a area portal using triggers. I'm going to make this wall into a func underscore breakable. And then I'm going to duplicate this wall and make the duplicate into a func underscore area portal. I'm going to call the area portal portal 1. Select the area portal texture and apply it to the area portal. And then select the func breakable. Go to the outputs tab. My output named on break, target entities named portal 1, via this input open. So now the portal will open when the func breakable breaks. Let's set the initial state of the portal to closed and set it in place and compile the map. Let's do impulse 101 to get all the weapons and then destroy it, and you'll see it'll start rendering what's behind the wall as soon as it breaks. If we didn't use an area portal there, what was behind the func breakable would be rendered even though the func breakable was there, because entities don't block visibility. If you learned something from this tutorial, please favorite it and give it a thumbs up. If you have any requests for what my next tutorials should be on, give me a comment below, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye!